To date, many legitimately different viewpoints about the proper mix of policies and programs have been accommodated in order to produce this bill. Because I believe that this bill comprises an awful lot of hard work, bipartisan hard work, so vital to the future of our country as a whole.
Long ago, on the eve of the Civil War, President Abraham Lincoln made a heartfelt plea to the American people. Though passion may have strained, it must not break our bonds of affection. The mystic chords of memory will yet swell when again touched by the better angels of our nature. In a nation as divided as ours, how can we answer Lincoln's call? How can we heed the better angels of our nature? We can start with practicing civility. Civility is the indispensable political norm. It is the public virtue that has greased the wheels of our democracy since its inception. Although nowhere mandated in our Constitution, civility is no less essential to the proper functioning of our government than any amendment, court ruling, or act of Congress. Without it, little separates us from the cruelty and chaos of rule by force. Sadly today, we face an unfortunate reality. Civility has all but vanished from the public square. Take the Senate as an example. The culture has shifted fundamentally, and not for the better. There used to be a level of congeniality and kinship among colleagues that was really hard to find anywhere else. In the early years of my public service, I counted Democrats among my very best friends. One moment, we would be locking horns on the Senate floor. The next, we would be breaking bread together over family dinner. My unlikely friendship with the late Senator Ted Kennedy embodied the spirit of goodwill and collegiality that used to thrive there. Teddy and I were a case study in contradictions. He was a dyed-in-the-wool Democrat. I was a resolute Republican. But by choosing friendship over party loyalty, we were able to pass some of the most significant bipartisan achievements of modern times.
And I enjoyed being with him. You know, we were like fighting brothers. I mean, we'd go at each other, and then he'd walk up to me and throw his arms around me and say, "How'd I do?" You
know? Now, years after Teddy's passing, it's worth asking, could a relationship like this even exist in today's Senate? Could two people with polar opposite beliefs from vastly different walks of life come together as often as Teddy and I did for the good of the country? Or are we too busy vilifying each other to even consider friendship with the other side? Our challenge then is to restore civility to its proper place. We can do this by choosing compassion before enmity and patience before impulse. May we all work together toward this noble goal. Today, and every day, may we strive to heed to the better angels of our nature by recommitting ourselves to civility.